Rocket Arena is not the Rocket Arena that many older PC gamers might remember. Back in the late 90s and early 2000s, Rocket Arena was the go-to mod for the Quake series, stripping away everything but each game's iconic rocket launcher and having you do battle on a truly level playing field. Now, in 2020, those classic mods are little more than a hazy memory for 30-something PC gamers, and with SpaceX making rockets all kinds of cool again, Final Strike Games have decided that it's time to bring Rocket Arena back. Or at least, the name, anyway. Because there's a lot that is different here compared to those purest deathmatch mods, throwing modern gaming trope after trope into the pot and letting them all stew into something that feels completely different. Two of the most fundamental things about Rocket Arena do remain though. Everyone is equipped with a projectile-based rocket launcher, and rocket jumping, that is, propelling yourself through the sky using the force of your own rocket's explosions, is a key part of getting around. Everything else, however, is completely different. You notice this immediately as you load up the game. There's no gritty Quake Marine here, but fun and friendly character designs that wouldn't be out of place in Fortnite. And yes, they're each a distinct character as well. This is now a hero shooter. Each one has got their own rocket launcher, each with a unique rate of fire and damage output, which kind of makes a mockery of the old Rocket Arena mods, and they've also got a secondary fire and a special ability. So you've got the very default basic character looking Jato, who comes with the most standard rocket launcher and whose secondary fire is a swarm of mini rockets, while his special boosts his mobility and gives him much more powerful sky piercer rockets for a short time. However, it's not always going to be rockets. Amphora can turn into a pool of water, moving around and then cycloning upwards as her special ability, while Rev rides around on a hoverboard that can be used to ram enemies and will throw a mine as her secondary, but she's got a much weaker, faster firing main rocket launcher. Then there's Boone, who basically feels like he just doesn't shoot rockets at all. He's got a shotgun-like cluster shot as his primary fire and a scoped sniper rocket as his secondary, and then he's got a wind vortex special attack. The few unifying aspects are that they all move around at kind of the same speed, they've also all got a triple jump, and their weapons are all projectile-based, meaning that there's still skill needed to lead your target and then land successive blows. And you'll really need to do that, because taking out an enemy isn't about dropping their health bar to zero in Rocket Arena. Instead, you'll be filling up an impact meter, with each successive rocket imparting a greater and greater force until the meter is full and you can send them flying out of the arena with what's called a Mega Blast. Think Super Smash Bros, but where you can actually run away and hide to let it reduce back down to zero. So yeah, there's a lot of ideas being thrown together here, but somehow it still works. There's still something so utterly satisfying about the skill needed to lead a target and hit them a few times on the trot. Putting the Rocket Arena name to one side, and it feels like there is a really inventive combination of different gameplay ideas here that will appeal to a lot of people that actually give it a try. Those game mechanics are thrown into a handful of game modes at launch, each with a low 3v3 player count. The first and most obvious is Knockout, where it's all about getting the highest number of knockouts as a team. You can really feel the impact of three of you ganging up on one enemy to get a few quickfire hits and knock them out of the arena. The second mode then puts a sports ball spin on things, with a ball spawning in the middle of the map that you have to try and snatch and then score at the other team's base, whether throwing it or running it in. Finally, there's Treasure Hunt, which alternates between two phases, where you first try and grab and hold a treasure chest that earns you points as you run around and try and avoid getting knocked out, and then a second phase which will have you sprinting around grabbing coins that spawn on the map. There's more modes on the way as well, with the game set to follow the Battle Pass model for rewards and a seasonal stream of new characters, modes, and maps. Unfortunately, that is where I feel that the game could take a little bit of damage from its own rocket. EA and Final Strike Games are charging for the game up front, albeit at a budget $29.99 price point, and then following that up with a Battle Pass model more typical of free-to-play games. Yes, we've seen examples like Call of Duty where this has seemingly managed to work, but let's not forget that that is a game that is always going to sell millions and millions of copies, regardless of how Activision decides to monetize it. By contrast, Rocket Arena is starting from scratch, and so it feels like a little bit more of a risk. That said, I think that anyone that does give this game a try when it arrives in July will actually have a lot of fun with it. Going into the game with a ton of preconceptions from the old mods, I was surprised at every turn by Rocket Arena. Maybe change isn't so bad after all. Thanks for checking out our video about Rocket Arena. The game is out on the 14th of July. It's coming to PlayStation 4, Xbox One and PC with full crossplay between these platforms. There's 10 characters, there's 10 maps, there's 4 PvP game modes and 1 cooperative PvE mode, and there's also a ton of stuff and progression to work through. We will be back with our full review around about the time of launch. In the meantime, make sure to like, subscribe, and share, and hopefully we will see you again soon. Goodbye!